Shalom, beloved of God. I have a message for the church in Kenya in this season. This is what the Lord says to the church in Kenya. As we celebrate our Madaraka Day on 1st of June 2020, the Lord says, Kenya is my beloved nation and my tool of revival. And as you celebrate Madaraka Day, I usher this nation into a new season and a new time. A new season that I am unveiling my own servants that have been in the hiding, men and women of honor. This is what Adonai Elohim says, that there is a change of guard in the house of the Lord, that the church will experience some difficult times, but the gates of hell will not prevail against the church, and the persecutions will be the birth pangs for the revival. And it has pleased the Lord to use women on the forefront of this revival in a swift anointing for this generation. And for the fathers of the land, the bishops, the pastors, the presbyters, the prophets, the teachers, and the evangelists, the Lord says that many of you have grieved him. You were anointed for a reason. To preach the message of the kingdom, to make disciples, to heal the sick, to help the poor, to provide refuge for the homeless, for the orphans and the widows. But what have you done? And the Lord says that wisdom and might belongs to him. The times are in his hands. He changes the seasons. And you have not pleased the Lord, not all of you. The Lord has a remnant in this generation. But as he spoke to Isaiah, he says that he is doing a new thing. He's shaking the heavens and the earth, and only the things that are of him are going to remain. As he talked to Ezekiel in his time, he's talking to the fathers of the land, that you have led the sheep in cruelty, that you have fed yourselves and fattened yourself, and the Lord is not pleased with you, fathers of the land. You have preached your own message, you have exalted yourselves and become idols in his house. The Lord says that you no longer tremble at his word. You are sluggish in performing his instructions. He has sent servants to come and help you and support you and ensure that you fulfill the purpose he anointed you. But you have fought them, you have slandered them, and you have rejected the servants he sent to help you. And for that reason, the Lord says he also rejects you from being priests before him forever. But as for your sons, your spiritual sons and your biological sons that are crying before him, the Lord says they will not bear your iniquity. The Lord says that he has kept for himself the Obadiahs, the Elishas, and the Deborahs, the men that you despised and rejected. And in this new season, his favor is with them. But as for you that remain stubborn, the Lord resists you. The women ministers that have used servants of God and manipulated them. You have blessed what the Lord did not bless. And you have said, thus says the Lord, when the Lord did not send you. The Lord says that he will lift up your skirts and the nations will behold your nakedness. Women ministers that have manipulated the church of God. The state of the nation, the Lord says, is determined by the church. Like Paul talked to Timothy and said that leaders are anointed of God, but God gives us a wicked leader because of our stubbornness, or he gives us a righteous leader because of our obedience. And we are the salt and the light of this nation. And if salt loses its savor, it is thrown and it is trampled upon. Light shines in darkness, it's not hidden. But the servants have not shone the light, but they have hidden the mysteries of the kingdom. And so the Lord has reserved for himself a generation that is going to perform his zeal. Father, I want to thank you for the ministers as they hear this word, and the prophets even as they judge the word from your mouth, that God, you are helping us as we humble before you in repentance, that you are healing our land. And Father, we are praying that we will not lose our inheritance to our enemies as a nation, but restore us as a nation and grant us peace. Shalom. May the Lord bless you as you walk in obedience in prayer and fasting for the sake of our nation, Kenya. God bless you.